I'm Maria, and today I am going to show you how to choose a WordPress theme that won't slow down your site. Knowing how to choose a WordPress theme is critical, but with thousands of themes out there, it's not always straightforward. How can you know which ones are good or which ones will frustrate your visitors with slow loading times? There's no hard and fast rule to finding a suitable theme, but in this video, I will give you tips that will help you know what to keep an eye out for and what to avoid. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's look at what to consider when selecting a WordPress theme. Many themes will try to dazzle you with flashy designs and thousands of features, and it's easy to fall for the trap. But often, the best theme is the simplest one, the one that does its job and nothing more or less. A simple look can go a long way, and for non-designers, it's often the best choice and the one that's easiest to work with. A pleasing layout, a few tasteful animations, plenty of customization options, and you have yourself a great theme. The most important thing is that your site is functional, readable, and does its job while not looking generic and bland. Pick a theme that's beautiful but simple, with enough features to add your touch to it without going off the rails. You may think that it's okay to use any theme as long as it's well-coded and not full of obvious problems. But the truth is, a theme that was top of the line 3 years ago may today be full of outdated code and glaring security vulnerabilities. The internet is ever-evolving. Every year, coding standards are updated and leave your current theme's HTML full of conflicts. Plus, new versions of systems like PHP are released regularly, and existing vulnerabilities become apparent as hackers discover them. That's why it's not a good idea to use add-ons that haven't been updated in over 2 years. Over time, more and more bugs and security issues will become apparent. You'll have no support if you can't update to the latest PHP version. Weekly or monthly updates aren't necessary, but you should expect a few updates a year to fix bugs and address vulnerabilities. It's a good idea to look at the support forums and see if issues are being resolved to this day. If the theme hasn't been updated in several years and the support forums are full of unresolved complaints, it's best to move on. The problem with feature-packed themes is that they can instantly bloat your site and leave your load times extremely slow. And that's all before you do any customization or install plugins. Lightweight themes are always best. Themes below 200 to 600 kilobytes can be called truly small, while anything around 2 to 3 megabytes is an acceptable range. Anything more indicates a very likely case of bloated software full of features you'll never use. While this isn't a universal rule, you want your site to start as small as possible as the page size will inevitably increase as you add in content and start installing plugins. Every theme worth its salt will list itself as responsive. You're likely well aware of the mobile boom. 90% of internet users browse with a mobile device, whether that's a phone, tablet, or smartwatch. There are a variety of different screen sizes out there. The solution is responsive design, websites that adapt to your screen size. Before purchasing a theme, it's worth visiting the demo page on your phone or at least resizing your browser window and seeing how it looks on smaller screens. Images should scale properly and the layout change without any strange effects. If a theme isn't responsive, it's simply not worth using. It's rare to find a plugin and theme that don't go together, but incompatibilities exist. Carefully read over the documentation to see if any wanted plugins don't play well with your theme of choice. More than that, you may want to look out for themes that integrate with certain plugins. While a theme that outright requires dozens of plugins can be a red flag, it can be a nice bonus to know that it will work well with popular caching, security, and e-commerce plugins. It's always a good idea to check out the ratings. Reading through reviews can give you a good insight into what most people like and dislike about the theme, and what features are most impactful. For a more balanced look at the theme, please pay attention to 3- and 4-star reviews, as users are more likely to give a reasonable explanation of what they liked and disliked. And of course, 2-star and 1-star reviews could give you an idea of what isn't going so great. You can also search for third-party reviews that can go in-depth, but look out for people using affiliate links and find an unbiased source that tried out the theme. These won't help you know what it's like to use it long term, but they should at least give you an idea of how appealing the design is and how easy it is to work with. It's always a good idea to pick an SEO-optimized theme, but it can be hard to tell at a glance whether it fits the criterion. Most SEO optimization goes on under the hood and has to do with the underlying structure of the page. While every theme will say that it's SEO-optimized, not all of them are. Unless you're well-versed in HTML5, you might not know how to tell if it's genuinely made well. Still, SEO-friendly themes generally have small sizes and fast speeds, responsive design, and good HTML structuring. Look for tells like improperly nested headings, multiple H1 headings, confusing navigation menus, and messy HTML code to know that a page's structure is poor. Remember that most SEO optimization involves creating high-quality content, so it is primarily on you. Much like with SEO, every theme will say it's safe and secure, but there's no way to test this claim without being familiar with code. And unlike SEO, there are no easy tells of a poorly secured theme without digging through the source code. You can use a tool like a theme checker plugin or an online scanner like Security Site Check. These are most effective when tested on your site. There's no need to be alarmed if there are just a few issues, as it'd be impossible to code a theme that threw no warnings at all. And not all are the theme's fault. But if you're seeing several prominent notices pop up, it may be time to switch. There's also the issue of themes themselves coming bundled with malware. To avoid this, stick with reputable vendors like the official WordPress theme repository or popular third-party ones like Template Monster or Theme Forest. Don't install software from unknown sites without much research, and also pirated or nulled themes. If you plan on translating your site and making it available to people worldwide, it's imperative to pick a theme that lists itself as translation ready. Such themes have the files in place to let you reference your translation files and swap out text on the page as needed, as well as working with RTL languages and non-Latin alphabets. That might sound simple, but it'd be an absolute nightmare to set up on your own. Even if you don't plan on translating your site right now, you never know if down the line you'll end up with several hundred thousand visitors and might want to start thinking and localizing your content and bringing in international visitors. Instead of having to switch to a new theme or pay a developer to get it translation ready, pick one that's already done the work for you. You now know what to look for in a theme, but what are the things you want to avoid? I want to share with you four aspects you should stay away from when deciding on a theme. Theme bloat is a severe problem for you and your visitors. A theme packed to the brim with features isn't likely to be user-friendly, and these will massively inflate its size and single-handedly ruin your website speeds. A common sight when you visit a theme description is a massive list of features that seem to go on and on. But this is a good thing, right? Why purchase something simple when you can get all of these features for the same price? The truth is, you'll never use all of these several hundred tiny features, but they're still there, bloating the file size and slowing down your site. Plus, more features equal more potential security holes. That's why you should use a lightweight theme and only install the plugins you need. Inactive support is never a good sign. Whether you need help installing a theme or fixing a bug that suddenly crops up, it's always good to have the official developers to turn to. And if there's no support, that's a good sign that it isn't being updated anymore. Finally, it's crucial to avoid themes that aren't built with accessibility in mind. This will cause problems for assistive device users and be time-consuming to fix by yourself, even if you're familiar with code. Themes may say they're accessible, but make sure they list specific steps they've taken. This may include screen reader optimization, keyboard shortcuts, or special features like 2021's contrast color picker. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.